I'm John Shumway, back out on Route 30, and actually not on Route 30 now. It's no longer there. We're down on Electric Avenue looking up at the remainder of the slide that came down on Saturday morning. You'll remember last week we were showing you Route 30 dipping and dipping, and finally it gave way early on Saturday morning. Behind me you see a couple of the big excavators from Allison Park Contractors. And basically what they're doing is they're trying to shelf off an area so that they can bring in drilling rigs. The drilling rigs will drill down and figure out exactly how far they're going to have to go down to find bedrock. More and more equipment is coming in. In fact, even as we speak, a big front end loader, big pushing machines coming in from Allison Park Contractors. We're going to unload that here in a second. More equipment to get this job done. But this is a really delicate situation. They've already taken down two of the apartment buildings that were back here. There's a possibility more may have to go, but they haven't figured that part out. You also have this house up on the hill. Now, they don't know whether that is helping to hold up more of the hillside or not, so they're doing some studying to determine whether or not it's going to have to come down, or do they leave it in place to help with the stability of this whole situation? Eventually, here's what's going to happen. They're going to clear out the slide, all the quote-unquote bad material, and then they're going to build a wall. You talk about a wall. You've seen them along Route 28 and other places that are prone to slides. Well, they are going to build a massive wall that is going to go up, and then they will backfill in behind that wall. And when they backfill in behind the wall, they'll give stability to rebuild Route 30 on top of that. Now, I'm told just the process of taking down the material that fell is a couple of weeks. Building the wall, many more. And in fact, we're talking about, as you heard the transportation secretary say yesterday, this is a month's process. I'm being told two or three, maybe more. We'll have to wait and see on that. But at this point, the stability up above is not that they can get to the top and start digging down, because they're afraid if they do, anything they put up there might end up bringing more of this hillside down. In fact, the whole process is delicate from that standpoint. They don't want to do anything to cause more of a slide. So, meticulously, they're going to dig away at it, slowly but surely, until they get to a point where they know they can build the wall. Once they build the wall, they'll backfill behind it, and then they'll rebuild the road. Meanwhile, take a look at the traffic that is backed up here on Electric Avenue. It is going all the way back up into almost Forest Hills, and it's been that way all day. This is going to be with us for a while, as the traffic, 24,000 to 30,000 vehicles a day, are detoured because of this mess. We've got a lot more coming up for you tonight on KDKA-TV News at 5 and 6 o'clock. I'll see you then.